deal with airplane peanuts.
You're not going to believe this one. It was the last week of senior year, so we're just getting crazy. We're about to graduate. So we're at this park having a big keg party, just middle of the day. So then...
Is this high school or
this
college?
Is high school. I went to a Catholic high school. We're in our uniform. Yeah. We got like a half day. So we're like, let's go to the park. We've got a keg. We're out there. It's like, you know, 100 of us drinking. So my friend Packy, who was like a sophomore, he wasn't Pakistani. His name was like like Pakenstein, Jeff Pakenstein or something. So we called him Packy.
And he shows up with my friend Dirty Turk.
So he was this crazy kid who we let hang around us. He was way younger. He was like 2 feet tall, skinny as hell, but he would do anything you said. Like, go jump off that building, go say a racial slur in front of that guy's
face. That's like
face.
A jackass.
Kind it of was joke. Like Jack, but yeah, he was yeah, yeah, fearless.
That guy really shined for a little bit.
He was.
I think his name's Steve-O.
Yeah.
And he's still doing pretty good.
In and out of boarding school, like parents killed themselves in front of him. One of these kids, you know, just seen it all. He was up for anything. So he goes, oh, I got to get something. Oh, there's a house party. There's a house party. So we jump on in my car at a convertible. We jump in my car. We're going to this house party. We're in our uniforms and everything. And I'm trying, it's rush hour now, so I'm trying to get into a lane to merge off the highway. And I go, hey, man, can I get in? Can I get in? The guy goes, nope. Gives me like a hard nope. And I was like, fuck this guy. So I get in behind him, and I bump him just for the hell of it. We're hammered. It's 5 o'clock. We're shit-faced.
I bump him.
I give him a little taparoo. So then he's like, he's in the mirror.
I love the idea of drunk driver being like, I just gave her a little taparoo. Who cares for kids aren't around?
A little tea-tie tapper.
So he's like, in the mirror, like, what the fuck's going on here?
Into my car.
And we're doing like the, blow me. He had a ponytail. It was a whole thing. No offense. And
I have a ponytail. You. Whatever, you fucking drunk boat dad.
So he's like, fuck you, I'll kill you, whatever. And then we're like, oh, this guy wants to play. So I tap him again. Now he puts his car in park.
That would send me over the edge. That would make me so goddamn mad. Yeah, like if you did it, like you were like, wait,
look
this,
back,
this is when
horrible.
We were in the beginning. We go, what's wrong with Mark's brain? I love that Mark goes, oh, this guy wants to play, huh? So I tap him again.
What state is this in?
Louisiana.
New Orleans. This is New Orleans. So he puts the car in park. He gets out. So now we're like, well, I guess this is on, you know? Yeah. But there's two of us. I got Packy here. Packy will fucking just lunge at him like a rat. You know?
Packy, real quick, take out his knees.
Yeah, I'll just, you know, claw his neck. So he gets out and he walks past me. So I'm kind of like ready. Walks past me, goes to the back of the car, reads my license plate, memorizes it, walks back up, slams his fist on my hood, and gets in his car. And I was like, huh, well, that was weird. So now traffic's kind of moving a little bit, and I'm like, fuck this guy, what?
Cop?
No. He had sandals on and shorts. He was like a hippie kind of guy. So now I'm like, well, that was weird, but he's on a cell phone. This is when cell phones were like, if somebody's on a cell phone, you noticed it.
Yeah.
A big brick. And I was like, oh, that's weird. So now we're on the main streets, and I'm following him, but something's up. And then he gets to a green light, stops, and I stop behind him. And everybody's like, why isn't this guy going during the green light? There's a bar on the corner. A guy runs out of the bar, jumps in my convertible.
Jesus Christ.
Crazy. He had a leather jacket on. He was just day drinking at some bar. It was fucking, we're like, he's in the back and I'm trying
Even
to drive.
Packy?
Yeah, Packy. So I'm driving now. The guy in the car peels off. He's like, I'm out of here. Fuck these guys. But my friend will handle this, the ex-con or whoever that guy is. The guy who waits at bars for the phone call. So,
Bill, it's for you. It's Jeff. I've been waiting for this call for 5 years. This man saved my life back in Nam, and I owe him one.
He just pushes his drink for it. He goes, put it on my tab.
He just takes a drink, shoots it, and he goes, fill another one. I'll be back in five.
He runs his fingers. Door slings open, cling, 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 jumps in the back seat, pulls Packy back there. They're having a fist fight on their knees in the back seat, just like a cartoon. So I'm just like, driving, looking backwards,
why
trying to not kill
why
myself.
Are you still driving?
Because we're on the street. The street is moving. So I'm like, and I'm like trying to do swings like back here, like trying to help Packy, like doing some backward hammers, you know?
Like
trying
to get this guy.
Like a mom disciplining her children in the backseat. You guys stop it.
Yes, exactly.
I will turn this car around.
Exactly.
Take you back to your creepy bar.
So this is a man. This is a guy's, you know, balding. He's got a leather jacket on with patches on it. And, he's got a half a beard. This is a dude.
Beating up kids in
a
convertible.
Beating up a kid, but. Oh. That retard mom strength kicks in where you're just like scared for your life, you know, fight or flight. So Packy's like, one of those, you know, like windmill, 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 windmill. And so I just scream. I go, Packy, push him out. Push him out. So Packy gets some kind of demon in him, and he just gets up under the guy and goes, ah! And the guy goes over the back seat, off the trunk, rolls onto the street, and then like cars by and go, woo, woo, try not to hit him. Somebody runs over his hand. And I'm like, ah! The guy goes, ah! I'm like, oh my God, what is happening? So we go to the house party, and we're like, oh my God, you're not going to believe. We're telling everybody. I got a whole powwow around the living room. I'm like, this crazy Packy pushed him out. It was insane. And Packy's just sitting in the corner smoking, not saying anything. He was a psycho. I think he's since died. But
you should have Packy with you at all times.
I think he's dead now.
Yeah, there's no way that guy's alive.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
He got the hit or something.
Packy took that guy's seat at the bar.
Yes, exactly.
Were you there for Katrina?
I was an hour away, but on my family was there and all my friends were there. I was at LSU in Baton Rouge.
That's the capital.
Yes. I don't know why.
Yeah.
It's kind of like Albany. What
did you go to LSU? Is that where you graduated from?
Well, I didn't graduate from there. I had to finish online because I started comedy.
But is LSU crazy fucking party school?
Crazy party. I mean, those football games, it was like the Coliseum. It was unbelievable.
Right.
Got beat up a few times. Got arrested once. Great fun story.
Tell me.
They wouldn't allow booze in the stadium, you know, Tiger Stadium, huge, thousands and thousands of people. So we would line our chest with Ziploc bags full of whiskey.
Okay.
And so we're walking in, and some cop goes, hey, let me pat you down there. You know, I'm like, ah, fuck. So me and my friend are there. He pats down. He feels the squishy titties. He's like, what's this? He left the shirt. We're all lined up with whiskey bags. And he goes, all right. And he grabs us. And he, like, puts us down on the table. They rip the whiskey off of us. And then a fight breaks out, like, 20 feet away. Just melee, fist fight. So they all the cops run over there. My friend grabs the ticket book that he was filling out. It was like this leather-bound ticket book that you give citations with. And so we left the game. We ran around the campus just giving people fake tickets. And it was great. We're like, hey, you're too hot to handle. You're under arrest, fatty. And we give it to some lady. And it was so fun. So we still have that book.
That's fucking great.
But yeah, wild times, great school, great town, great time.
Because you used to be a porker back in the day, right?
College, I was okay. But yeah, I was just a skinny dweeb in college, you know.
Right.
But it was just so fun. You know, we're like, well, hey. You know, you try to do the whistle.
Yeah.
Like, hey, skank, that skirt's too short. You're going to have to sit on my face. Here, you know. And
bang.
All good time.
We had the guy, I shouldn't say his name, but Hunter Brown. And he was the fucking scariest, most fearless guy. And he would do shit that was just mean for his sake. Like, it was just funny to him. And no one else liked it. It was like, damn, that's cold-blooded. But he was like, he's laughing in the corner. Like, one time he was standing by a keg at a party. And he's like, you need a refill? Give me that. And he would turn around and pour it. And I looked over and his dick was in the cup while he's filling with beer. And I'm like, who does that help? Yeah. You know, like, it gives you a quick giggle, but this guy's drinking your dick juice now. And it doesn't hurt him enough, really. I don't know. There's no point to it except
for
fucking
him,
with people.
Yeah.
Is he like a tough guy, too?
He could be. He would fight if you wanted him to, but he was just all about mischief. Like, one time he was like, we got to put this grandfather clock in the pool. And I'm like, I don't know, man. That's an old clock. I think weighs 1,000 pounds. He's like,
seems
really
important
it.
To somebody. Yeah.
So we're sitting on the couch drinking a beer, trying to make out with girls and stuff. And he's like, all right, I'll get the skateboard. You bend it over, then we'll prop it up on the skateboard. We'll wheel it right out of here. I'm like, but then we have to leave. And he's like, I know, but it'll be great. He was that guy. And now he's like the treasurer for a big college. So I don't know how they hired his ass.
Hunter Brown does sound like the treasurer of a college. Just
we've had two threesomes together, me and Hunter. Really? He's the guy who filmed me with the video camera when the girl sat on my face.
Oh,
that was him.
What is that?
Yeah.
Jesus. What is,
yeah, what college, you, man.
Yeah.
Good times.
All right.
Basically, I was plowing a rotund lady, and I couldn't get it up anymore. So I said, all right, just come up here and I'll pleasure you while you
sit. So instead of you, I think that's a nice thing.
But I had her knees on both sides of me, and I look over and I heard giggling. My friend's holding a VHS style camcorder like on the shoulder, and he's just in the doorway, like, and then she gets up. She's like, what the fuck? And she's chasing him, and he's filming her while running. This is all going to get me in trouble. But
you didn't do anything. You didn't.
Yeah, I didn't do anything.
Fat chicks give. They're generous.
Yeah, they really like it. So tell me, the fattest fatty you've ever fatted.
I banged a gal once from the boot. This is in New Orleans. That was a bar in the New Orleans, and it would shut down at like 6. And I was working this pig all night. And finally, she kind of let up and started dancing with me. And we started making out on the dance floor, and I could taste kielbasa. And then we go back to her, me and a friend. And he
Did
pulled.
Did she really have meat breath?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I was pulling Jimmy Dean out of her teeth. And my friend pulled like a good-looking lady. And he was like a hot guy who was like well-dressed. And so we go back to his place, but we were in, basically like seniors in high school. So he lived with his parents, and we had to fuck the gals in the same room as each other.
Oh.
And he had the hot one, and she's screaming and moaning. And I remember I was like sobering up, and I had the lady on the floor. And, you know, I was on top, and I kept rolling over, and I was still on top. And, you know, it was just I kind of wasn't getting it up. And then I have to hear him plowing away like a champ, and she's moaning and screaming, and my girl's like, everything okay?
You gotta work up a boner to your friend?
Yes, yes, yes. And she kept looking up like, I wish I was that gal, you know? And it was pretty
And
pretty
so did
brutal.
You. You wish you was that girl, too.
Yeah.
You looked at her. That was your first guy. You just giggled together. He goes, I know, right? We both wish you were that girl.
We all want to be that girl.
When we did our half-hour specials together in Boston, half-hour Comedy Central specials, you were fucking sick. Yet. What'd you have, poisoning or something like that?
H. pylori.
Yeah, what the fuck? Yeah, I remember, if you go watch Mark Norman's half hour, can we pull up Mark Norman's half hour Comedy Central special? His face is like having an allergic reaction to something, because Mark
bloated.
Is a skinny, Mark is fucking ripped. Yeah, let's get a look at this fat fucking face.
Look at that porker.
Yeah. So what's the story there? Because that was you look at that. Yeah, you're on.
They
you're,
tried to clean it up with some makeup, but yeah, this is Comedy Central. They won't let you have an inch.
They fucking won't let you have an inch. They folded and they fucking gave up. I had a pilot with them. I had an animated show. I'm taking it all to Netflix.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or True TV, most likely.
But I had shit running down my leg. I mean, it was
you were
a
shitting during this special.
I was shitting. They asked if I wanted to wear a diaper. You can see my face is so puffed.
Yeah, because I was gonna say because Mark is he's ripped. Normally, but the face is so puffy there.
And I'm in pain. Like, I've got fever. I'm sweating. They had to keep stopping. Like, hold on. They had to do the dab, you know, and then put me back in.
So what happened, though?
When you eat fecal matter.
You were eating ass.
Yeah, and I got this virus called H. pylori, and it was terrifying because it just, I was shitting like butter. I was pissing foam. I didn't know what was going on. And I took
pissing
all these,
foam?
I took all these STD tests, nothing. I was like, I got AIDS. It must be AIDS. So eventually, I go to this doctor, and he takes a blood sample, whatever. And he goes, 2 days later, he goes, are you sitting down? And I was like, oh, God, just give it to me. I've had it for like a week now. I don't know what it is.
No, it wasn't getting better any day ever. It was
nothing. No, I was getting worse. And I'm bloated as shit. I have all this TV stuff to do, and I had to do it because they don't give a shit. Comedy said, we'll reschedule for you. They don't give a shit who you are. And I was nobody. So the doctor was like, are you sitting down? I was like, yeah, yeah. He goes, you have H? And I just like fell out. I thought he was going to say HIV. And he goes, you have H. pylori. And I went, oh, what the hell is that? And he goes, just got to take one antibiotic and you're fine, you piece of shit. And I was like, all right, thanks. Yeah.
And then, but he's the one who told you it's from ingesting fecal matter?
Yes.
Do you remember whose ass it was? There were so many.
I think it was Amy Schumer. No, I don't know.
It's going to be a joke.
Yeah.
That's why these queefs on Twitter who give me shit, they go, this sucks. There's nothing here. You're a comedian. You do this for a living. You cum guzzling Nazi. Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yeah, yeah, but give it time, you fat douche. Takes time.
You have that joke raider. That's not you, is it?
I hate the joke raider.
Really?
Yeah.
What a tweet
cunt. I know. I mean, look, I hate the guy. He's a dweeb, but the joke's on him. You got to sit there and stare at my Twitter all day or get a ping every time I tweet? Like, have at it, dickless. I don't care.
Do you look at his ratings ever?
I have to, because he gets it in, like, within 4 seconds of me sending the joke. So I'm like...
Who is this?
It's called Mark Norman Joke Raider.
He's got my avatar. He's got my name in there. It's crazy.
There was, at a time, there was a Mark Norman Joke Raider.
Yeah, that guy I like.
Yeah, because he was like... He would, like, defend you, too.
Yeah. And look, I'm not mad at the guy. He can do whatever the fuck he wants. I'm just saying, it's a little... annoying, because you're like, I'm trying to work out here, man. Don't just grade me off my first attempt.
Yeah.
You know,
it's like
but,
being at the gym, and they're like, you're fat. It's like,
that's why I'm here, fucker. I'm trying to work it out.
So you tweeted, I just saw a KKK member at a Wawa. He should be at a Sheetz. Great joke.
Thanks. It only got 47, I think, as it involves a KKK.
8.3 is the Mark Norman Joke Raider, and Mark Norman Joke Raider gave that an 8.5 rate.
Well, I had a joke today that I think is a 10.
Yeah.
And I don't say that often. And I wonder what he gave that one. I notice he's real quiet on the killer jokes. Mm. He's quick to pipe up on a mediocre. But I rarely see him.
You might know the guy.
I might.
Could be me. Could be Tucker.
Is it?
It's not, I promise.
Oh, jeez.